Hey guys, Matt here from mksmarthouse.com, and in this video, I'm going to be giving you the detailed explanation. So the point of this video is to tell you exactly in detail how this whole entire system works and how I'm going to teach you. So to start off, we're going to talk about what is MK-SmartHouse. Well, MK-SmartHouse is a resource or solution I created to show people how to make certain devices to either control things like blinds or sense changes such as a door opening. But my favorite part about these devices is that they are super simple to make. And so both of these are quotes taken from mksmarthouse.com/about, which is where you can find more information about exactly what is MK-SmartHouse. And here we have a little picture of the door sensor, showing how simple it looks and how it is to make. So the system, how it all works. So let's talk about the network. The network is the most important part of this smart house system. It's how all of the sensors, control devices talk to the main server. So all the communication is through the network. Either it's wired or wireless. So the devices that connect to wired are the automation server and the media server. And then the devices that connect through wireless are the sensor devices and control devices. But as you can see, I made a note that says necessary Wi-Fi coverage throughout the entire home/property. Since that's how all the devices are going to connect to, it is very necessary and very important to have Wi-Fi coverage throughout your entire home/property. But we're going to talk more about the network in the next video, and we're going to be actually starting to set up the home automation system starting from the network. So the servers are another part of the network, and the first server is the home automation server. This is the central hub for all the smart devices. It controls all the automation, so all the rules and tasks you tell it to do every day. And the software that runs on this and is the main application that controls all the devices in the whole smart house system is OpenHAB 2. And so this is running on a Raspberry Pi. And we will be talking about OpenHAB 2 more in depth later on in this presentation. And then the next server we have is the home media server. So the home media server is the central hub for all pictures, videos, and files. It also controls the data, and the software that we use on this is Open Media Vault. So now let's move on to the sensor and control devices, because this is what actually makes the house smart and enhances it. So the hardware for these devices is an ESP8266. This is the main control and what makes the device smart, so you can call it its brain. So this is all on a custom PCB, so there's no wiring or guesswork required. If you don't know what a PCB is, then you can go ahead and do a quick Google search. It's basically a green piece of copper that all you have to do is just put components in and solder it together. There's no guesswork required. You just put it in. Another thing for the hardware is just some other small electronic components such as resistors, transistors, relays, temperature sensors. In this case, in the bottom right, we have a door sensor, so it's just a magnetic reed switch. And then for the software, we are going to be using the Arduino IDE to flash the ESP8266. And then the sensor and control devices are going to be talking to the main server through MQTT. And lastly, these devices connect to the home automation server. Now, if any of this sounded complicated at all, do not be worried at all. This is going to be made so simple that literally anybody can do it. All you have to do is just follow the step-by-step guides. There won't be any type of, oh, you should know this already. No. This is all going to be, I'm going to show you exactly the step, how to solder each component, where to put it. Literally every single detail is going to be in these guides. So OpenHAB 2 features. So this is the software, like I mentioned before, that's going to be running on the home automation server. So the user interfaces that it has is the HAB panel for wall mount interfaces. As you saw in my demo video, I had a wall mounted interface where I can control stuff and turn stuff on and on. And I also have a picture here to the right. And what's cool about HAB panel is you can design it exactly how you want it. You can move any tile how you want. You can make it however big you want, have a bunch of pages, change the icon. Literally, there's endless customization. Next, we have the iOS app. I also demoed this in my demo video, as well as the Android app and the web browser. I showed all these interfaces. But the thing with the iOS app is that you have native control and it includes notifications. And the same thing is said about the Android app. It has native control. It's one application. You press it. and then boom, you have your entire smart house system. And that one also has notifications. And then you have the web browser, which you can access your smart home from any web browser, anywhere, anytime you want. So another cool thing about OpenHAB is you have add-ons. So not only can you connect the devices that I'm going to show you how to make, but you can also connect other devices. So say you have a Samsung Smart TV, you can also connect that to the smart home system. And I'm also going to show you how to do that. And then lastly, we have rules. So this is what actually makes our system smart, because it's cool how you can turn stuff on and on manually with the wall-mounted interface and your phone. But what makes things smart is when it happens on its own without you even thinking. So with OpenHAB, you can create rules and automate things and routines. Also with rules, you can do sensor variables. So if the door opens, send a notification. If the fire sensor goes off, send a notification. If the door sensor goes on, turn on the lights. Literally endless possibilities. Love OpenHAB too. Now let's go over the entire system as a whole. So to the left here, we have the smart devices. So these are the sensor devices and control devices, and those connect to the network, mainly the Wi-Fi access points. And so then in the network, we have the Wi-Fi access points, which can be the router or an external Wi-Fi access point. And then you also have an Ethernet switch, which would connect to the servers. So the home automation server and the home media server. And then to the right, we have the user interfaces. So we have voice control, such as the Amazon Echo or Siri. Then we have phones, tablets, and web browsers, so the iOS app, the Android app, and any web browser. And then we have wall-mounted devices, such as the HAB panel or tablets we decide to mount on the wall. And as you can see, the arrows are all pointing towards the network, because that's what decides which information goes where. So now, information structure. If anything to this point at all sounded confusing, difficult, technical, do not worry, because this is all going to be made simple for you. As long as you can follow step-by-step instructions, you are going to be able to make this system. It's that simple. So speaking of the information structure, how I am going to teach you. Well, to start off, we are going to have two main resources. We're going to have the MK SmartHouse YouTube channel, which will show you the instructional guide in video form. Then we're also going to have the MK SmartHouse website, which is mksmarthouse.com or mk-smarthouse.com, whichever one. They both go to the same place. And this will show you the instructional guide in written form. So you will have both the guide in video form and in written form. So this is how the guide is going to be structured. There's going to be four main parts. So if we look at the YouTube video, there's going to be four YouTube videos. And then if we look at the written guide, there's going to be four written guides. So the first one is the device demo, and this is going to show the device in action and how it works. And then the second one is going to be hardware. I'm going to show you how to put the device together. So how to solder the components and place everything. Next is software. Mac and PC will have separate videos. So if you have a Mac, you're going to watch the video for Mac. And then if you have a PC, you're going to watch the video on PC. Now you may be asking, what's the difference? Well, the software and how you use the software is different on the different platforms. So when you flash a device or put the software onto the device you created, it's different between Mac and PC, and also accessing the home automation server is different on Mac and PC. So I'm going to show you how to configure the software for the devices that we create. And then we will have the final device installation. So I'm going to show you how to install the device for you. So we're going to actually install the device in the real world environment. Now this is what I feel puts my guides and YouTube channel and website different than any other. I show you the exact from start to finish and how it actually functions in the real world and how I use mine, because this entire system, I use it on a daily basis. Now, a very important factor is the shopping and parts. So the product links will be both on the YouTube videos as well as the website, mksmarthouse.com. To get our parts and tools, we're going to go to AliExpress, Amazon, and eBay. So we're going to first go to AliExpress. That's going to be our number one place to get it. And the reason we do this is because their stuff there is cheap and there's plenty of quantity for everybody. So they rarely ever run out of something. And then if we can't find it on AliExpress, then we'll go to Amazon. And if we can't find it on Amazon, then we'll go to eBay. So next is the PCBs. So where are we going to get the green PCBs, the main platform of each individual device? Well, we're going to get it from iTeed. I love iTeed. I've been using them for quite a while, and they create high quality PCBs at a very, very good price. Next, we're going to move on to questions or problems. So what if you have a question or are having trouble? The number one place is the community forum, which is mksmarthouse.com/forum. And the reason I say to go to the forum first is because when you ask your question, then other people who may have the same question can also have an answer answered at the same time, and they can all go to the same place. And then for future people, if they have the same question and want it answered, then it's also right there. And the second place is YouTube comments, which is the comment section of any YouTube video. Now this one I don't recommend because I have no idea how YouTube comments are going to go. I know exactly how the community forum is, and I know exactly how I want it to go, but YouTube comments is really unpredictable. And that, as a last resort, you can go ahead and contact me at mksmarthouse.com/contact. So overall, if any of this has been complicated at all, I stress again, do not worry. These guides will be detailed and very simple to follow. So this goes along with my overall statement. I'm going to make this system so easy to make that anyone can do it. They just need to follow the guide. So just follow the detailed guides and you will have a successful smart home system. So where to go from here? Well, number one, like this video, please. Number two, make sure you are subscribed to this channel. And number three, go to mksmarthouse.com and sign up for the email newsletter to receive updates. So if I find a common question among people, I can go ahead and answer in a mass email newsletter. I'll send you updates when there are new guides, new videos, and overall news that I have. And then number four, explore the MK Smart House website and YouTube channel. All right, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comments section below, or head over to the mksmarthouse.com forum, where you have a better chance of it getting answered. Goodbye.